I'm Tori, and today I am going to be reviewing Grave Witch by Kalayna. I listened to the audiobook narrated by Emily Durante, and I love this book so much. It was so much fun. So I've read several different books that are kind of in the style of One for the Money, where you have this plucky young woman who's going to go try to solve crimes by herself, and she's usually fairly scantily clad, and she's a bit of a loner, and she likes to just go handle things. And in One for the Money, I was always kind of amazed that she was still alive by the end of it, because it seemed very unlikely that she would be able to survive some of the situations she put herself in. So this book is very similar, except all those things take place in a world of magic, so it absolutely makes sense that she could take care of herself, because she has magical means of protection. And so it just made this story so perfect, and I had so much fun with it. So as far as I could tell, this story takes place in our world now, except 75 years ago, all the magical creatures decided to come out of the mushroom circle and announce themselves to the public. They did this because apparently fairies and fae need people to believe in them to actually exist, and people weren't really believing anymore, so they announced themselves to the world. And now it's been 75 years, and there have been other pockets in space found, and everyone's really gotten used to fairies and witches and all different kinds of magical beings in the world. And it's just a common part of everyday life. There are two different kinds of magical beings thus far. There are kind of witches and people who use spells, and there are fae and the kind of people who use fairy magic. And those are two kinds of different sorts of magic that don't interact well together. Because magic has become so popular, there is also a humans first movement that is a political force that's trying to restrict the laws of magical beings, or restrict the freedoms of magical beings, and put more emphasis on the protection of non-magic users. And there's this whole political system going on, and it was just so much fun. So our hero, Alexis Craft, is a grave witch. So that means that she has a magical power to communicate with the grave, and she can talk to ghosts and raise shades, which are like memories of ghosts, kind of, that can't lie. And so she makes her money by going around and taking her ceremonial knife and drawing magic circles so that she can raise shades to tell their children where the inheritance was left, or tell the police how they died, or different things like that. And so her world is so much fun. She works very closely with the police, and so she's always having to go in and talk to the police and stuff. And so she walks into the police station, and she walks through a metal detector and checks all her weapons, and then she walks through a magic scanner, and they get out the little wand that tells them if the charms that she's wearing are benign or if they're dangerous. She has a charm bracelet with actual magic charms on it that have magical properties. She has chalk for drawing magic circles inside, and a ceremonial knife for cutting magic circles into the grass and stuff when she's outside. And it's so much fun because magic exists in this world, and it's still very magical, but it's also incredibly practical, and there are ways to detect it. You can tell if a spell or a charm is in use. There are schools, and magic users get certified for different things. And because of this, you know, like, healing charms have become very common. They use them in, like, ambulances are stocked with them, and people tend to have them in case of medical emergencies. There are complexion charms and different, like, makeup charms that people will use just to enhance their image. There are all different kinds of really cool things. Magic is regulated. There are rules about what kinds of spells you can or can't use. It's just such a fun world, and I had so much fun getting to know it. Everything was explained so well, and you just kind of walked through the world and kind of saw how things worked, and you were just kind of introduced to everything, and I had so much fun. And one of the things that Alex Craft does is that because she works so closely with the dead, she has a very good working and even social relationship with death. There are several different soul collectors, and we don't quite figure out what the difference is between them. You just kind of get the feeling that they need multiple soul collectors to do different things. And the one that Alex works most closely with, she just refers to as Death, and he's not a hooded specter or anything. He's just a guy about her age who walks around in, like, I think jeans and a t-shirt, you know, very simple, and he just shows up and collects souls, or he'll come by for a cup of coffee now and then. You know, whatever. This story was so much fun. It had all the elements of, like, a good, like, crime novel trying to figure out some strange things have been going on. What's happening? And because Alex is a grave witch, of course you see it's mostly murder things that have gone wrong. What's up with this body? And this is strange. Why is this behaving in this way? Well, this is a charm or spell that I've never seen before. And it's, you get tangled up in this whole complicated mystery trying to figure out what's happening. Why can't other people see these things? And it's so much fun. All the characters were so great. And I loved running around with Alexis and watching her stop everywhere to carve her magic circles. Because a magic circle is kind of like building a little safety fence that stops anything that's dead or magic or anything like that from crossing it. So she's always making her magic circles to protect things and running around working with spell books. This was a great novel. This is the first book in a series. It looks like it's still ongoing as far as I can tell. The most recent book came out just a few years ago. And so I look forward to continuing this series. It was so much fun. I can't wait to see what happens. There's intrigue, there's romance, there's a mystery to solve, there's family drama, there's everything you could want. This book was so much fun and I highly recommend it.